Hi, Stephanie Lessington from SimHQ, and I'm with Matt Wagner.
I'm from the Fire Collection Eagle Dynamics, and I'm here to show off A-10C Warthog.
Tell us about the campaigns and the missions included.
The campaign is in many ways a reverse of the campaign we did for DCS Black Shark. In Black Shark, the player played as a Russian Pa 50 helicopter pilot assigned to throw the NATO troops out of Georgia. In A-10C, you're going to kind of fight from the other side. Mm-hmm. We're going to be an A-10 pilot throwing the Russians out of Georgia.
What multiplayer features are included?
Everything we had before, but the big thing we've added this time, a lot because of a lot of the consumer feedback, was they wanted better lobby communications before even joining a mission, much less a server. So now, in our server browsers, you know, people can see different friends that are there, they can chat with them, they can create chat rooms, they can decide on what server they want to be on, they can join them, talk further about how they want to conduct the missions, and they go fly.
Oh, cool. What is the one thing that was most difficult to achieve in this project?
Probably the most difficult, and time-consuming wise, particularly for me, has been implementing a fully interactive AI-controlled JTAC, a Joint Terminal Air Controller, formerly known as FAC. When a player enters a mission, assuming there's a JTAC in it, they can contact the JTAC, they can tell them, how much playtime they have, what weapons they have on board, then JTAC gives them the full nine line, then JTAC can designate a target either through coordinates, through a laser designation, IR pointer, and you have multiple JTACs in the mission, so we're pretty proud of that, but it's been a lot of work.
Conversely, what was the surprisingly and unexpectedly easy thing to achieve in this project?
Thankfully, but also I think one of the most important aspects of A-10 has been communications in the game, which I think leads to a much more immersive experience in missions. Because unless you see or hear units taking part in a mission, you may never know they're there.
Mm-hmm.
So in A-10 now, you'll actually hear all the radio communications from not just your flight, AWACS, and tanker, but all flights now. Whether it's a seed flight, doing a seed flight behind you, B-1 coming in for a strike, you're going to hear all of them, whether it's from them taking off, passing through waypoints, spotting targets, rolling in on a target, you're going to hear it all now. So you're going to have a much more lively radio environment, assuming you have your two VHF radios and your UHF radio tuned to the frequencies that those flights were assigned in the mission.
What is the difference between DCS A-10 Warthog and the Battlefield Simulator?
The Battle Simulator is our military line that is based on the same code base as DCS, but we have some additional functionality in there that's very specific to the warfighter. But in terms of the engine, the graphics, and things of that sort, you're basically getting the same thing.
Is every munition carried by the actual A-10C included in the loadout?
Yeah, and that was one of the big benefits of starting this work in the military side of it on our DTS that we did for the Air National Guard and ACC, and that, as you might imagine, they're very specific that, virtually everything that the A-10C can carry, they wanted to see in the DTS. So as part of our agreement to do this game, we were able to pour a lot of that information into DCS as well.
Is the Manual Reversion Flight Control System, MRFCS, simulated?
Absolutely. It's there, as well as the full stability augmentation, the SAS system, EAC, and everything else, the LASTI system. Every aspect of the flight control system in the real A-10C is in DCS.
What code has been optimized for the Thrustmaster POTUS?
The big thing, which I think is going to make people very happy, is that assuming you're running A-10 and you plug the Warthog POTUS into it, our input system will automatically recognize them, whether it's the stick, the throttle, or the MPDs, and then automatically configure every button, every switch, every axis, and every tune of the axes to mimic the real A-10C. So the player's not going to have to make, you know, very complex profiles and anything else. It really is truly plug and play.
Awesome. Great. What is your favorite part of the DCS A-10 Warthog?
For me, it's probably the lightning pod. You know, like the DTS, we did a lot of work on that to make it a very accurate system. Mm-hmm. And, you know, flying around at 15,000 feet, you know, finding a target, you know, putting in a point track, sending a laser code, and, you know, setting that as your destination speed, and then, you know, either putting in the GBU 12 or a, you know, a JDAM 38, you know, through the guy's forehead. And that can be a lot of fun.
What copy protection will be used?
Same one as Black Shark, which is proactive. So they'll get 8 activations and 10 deactivations. But they can install the game, you know, a zillion times, it doesn't matter. And an activation is only needed after a significant hardware change. Even if an activation is needed, like let's say they're about to replace their CPU, they can deactivate it and not lose that activations. But worst case scenario, let's say they burn through all their activations. They're more than welcome to go to our website, and you know, as long as we can see that multiple people are using the same serial code, we'll be happy to give them more activations.
Okay. Still planned for 2010?
Absolutely.
Thank you for your time and answering questions for us. We really appreciate that, and I'm sure the viewers will appreciate it as well.
Well, I'm very glad to be here, and I'm really looking forward to everyone having me too.
Thank you.